that motherfucker. Kill the devil.
Must have been paid for with my dead friend's stashed millions.
Wow, that's a real mindfuck.
I'll show you a fucking mindfuck.
I'm gonna stick my boy in your eye. It's gonna come out of your ear, huh?
I didn't mean anything by that, P. Trevor?
Lube up your eye hole, fucker, because I'm gonna fuck your tiny mind, huh? I am about ready to turn you into roadkill.
Please, don't turn me into anything. I just want to be Wade. Are we nearly there yet?
No, Wade.
Are we nearly there?
You keep this up, you're not gonna get there at all.
Can you tell me a story?
No, Wade.
Let's play a game then. You know animal, mineral, or vegetable? I'll go first. I'm nanotechnology.
You're what?
Ooh, damn it. I gave it away. I wasn't supposed to say what I am. I'll start again. Animal, vegetable, or mineral?
Hey, how about this?
I'll tell you a story if you promise never to speak again.
I like stories.
Of course you do. This story's about a boy called Trisha.
Is Trisha a boy's name?
It doesn't matter.
Sounds weird.
He was weird. He was the smartest, toughest, weirdest kid in Canada. Well, in the Canadian border region of America.
Okay.
This boy, he had all the talent, charisma, and guile that a boy could have. But he didn't know what to do with it.
He should become a baseball player.
No, he shouldn't. Because he's not a fucking sellout idiot.
Or hockey player.
And he did for a while. But his coach accidentally had a stick jammed up his ass.
What could he do?
I'll tell you in a second, okay? Just let me concentrate on the road.
But Trevor!
Hey!
Aw.
That's it. That giant sprawl, Los Santos.
This is the place!
No,
I seen it on the holiday card. So, this is Los Santos.
I guess it is.
I always wanted to come here.
But you got stuck in the desert?
It's still San Andreas.
Best part of the state.
Yo, bitches out here scamming, bro! I try and ball out, but they just look for something better.
I don't know, it's like I flashed some chips and they want to know what I do, who I know. Hell yeah! Yo, bitch, are we fucking? No? Then don't worry about what I got and who I know. Yeah, gangster, that's right. Bros before hoes! Alright, peace out!
think about the loss no more. Let's go find my old buddy.
This Michael Townley guy must have pissed you off real bad for you to want to find him so much.
He didn't piss me off. The guys that killed him? The federal government. They pissed me off.
But if he's dead, who's this?
Now you're starting to grasp the pertinent questions. Who is this guy using my dead friend's tired-ass movie quotes? With my dead friend's alias? And my dead friend's family? In a house that must have been paid for with my dead friend's stashed millions?
Wow, that's a real mindfuck.
Yeah, I'll show you a fucking mindfuck.
I'm gonna stick my boy in your eye. It's gonna come out of your ear, huh?
I didn't mean anything by that, Pete. Trevor!
Move up your eye hole, fucker! Because I'm gonna fuck your tiny mind, huh? I am about ready to turn you into roadkill!
Please, don't turn me into anything! I just want to be Wade. Are we nearly there yet?
No, Wade.
Are we nearly there?
You keep this up, you're not gonna get there at all.
Can you tell me a story?
No, Wade.
Let's play a game then. You know animal, mineral, or vegetable? I'll go first. I'm nanotechnology.
You're what?
Ooh, damn it. I gave it away. I wasn't supposed to say what I am. I'll start again. Animal, vegetable, or mineral?
Hey, how about this? I'll tell you a story if you promise never to speak again.
I like stories.
Of course you do. This story's about a boy called Trisha.
Is Trisha a boy's name?
It doesn't matter.
Sounds weird.
He was weird. He was the smartest, toughest, weirdest kid in Canada. Well, in the Canadian border region of America.
Okay.
This boy, he had all the talent, charisma, and guile that a boy could have. But he didn't know what to do with it.
He should become a baseball player.
No, he shouldn't. Because he's not a fucking sellout idiot.
Or hockey player.
He did for a while, but his coach accidentally had a stick jammed up his ass.
What could he do?
I'll tell you in a second, okay? Just let me concentrate on the road.
But Trevor!
Hey!
Aw.
I guess it is.
I always wanted to come here.
But you got stuck in the desert?
It's still San Andreas.
Best part of the state.
sure what. Uh-huh. So he's like a totally important filmmaker, and this country totally needs to hear the story, like, right fucking now.
¿Cuál es tu problema, cabrón? Voy a patearte el culo. Anda. Me vale madre.
So, Michael, this is where dead men come back to life, huh? It's been nearly 10 years, but you'll keep for another day or so, huh, old friend? You motherfucking fuck! I grieved for you! You weren't even fucking dead. You were my best friend. Well, guess who's coming to shit on your doorstep, you fuck!
Lloyd ain't around here. What are you doing?
Los Santos, the city of shithead. Where else would he be?
It's the Fuji Beach where he's staying. Will you tell me the story about that boy, Trisha?
Ah, yeah, yeah. Where were we?
You were saying what he could do. He couldn't throw, and his coach had a stick accident like I had one.
Right, right. But he could fly planes, this kid. So he signed up for the Air Force to fly all day long and bomb villages and maybe, just maybe, drop the nuke. And it was all going well until one day, just before he got his wings, an evil witch in charge of psychological evaluations told him he was unstable. Grounded him for life.
That's terrible.
It was. It sent him into a deep pit of doubt and despair. And just then, just as he hit rock bottom, he met a fat, silver-tongued troll under a bridge.
That's cool. What was the troll's name?
Mike. Michelle.
A lady troll?
Yeah, he had tits like one, but no, he was a boy.
Michelle is a funny name for a boy.
Well, this was a funny boy. He sat under his bridge, robbing anyone who passed him by. Sometimes, he'd go into town and rob his shops and inns and such. And he persuaded our hero that maybe he should rob people too. And you know what? Little Trisha did rob people. And little Trisha was good at it.
And they lived happily ever after?
For a while. Until the troll met another troll in a strip club, and they fell in lust, and he bought her a pair of fake troll tits, even bigger than his real troll tits, so she could make more money stripping. Maybe a little on the side without call work, but you didn't hear that from me. Wow. And then she pushed out a pair of little trolls, and the big bad troll under the bridge went soft.
Hold on, what?
So little Trevor made a new friend called Brad, and he was thinking about cutting Mike off when it all went to shit and Mike got killed and Brad went to jail.
Did all the names just change, or am I missing something?
Shut up! And then the fat ugly troll came back from the dead, and the news picked it up. Our hero decided to go out looking for him.
I'm sort of following it, I think. But what happens in the end?
That, Wade, we do not know.
Oh, man. Fuck you.
near Floydcast. I'm seeing it on iPhone maps. I'll give you directions. You don't turn here. Go straight on here.
You and me, we're about to have a problem, man.
It's a rat up here. This one's a rat. This is the place, I think it is, at least.
Hey, stop by the hotel later.
Floyd! Floyd! It's up here, Trevor. Floyd, it's me, Wade.
Who?
Me, Wade, your cousin.
Who?
Your cousin! Fuck! He's come to visit you, you rude fuck! Now get up off the floor and fix me a fucking drink!
Oh, you wait! I heard you was off smoking meth somewhere.
No, not somewhere. Here, he's gonna smoke meth here! Give me a fucking lighter.
You can't smoke here.
Okay.
This is my girlfriend's place. She's at a business conference. You can't smoke here and you can't stay here.
How's it going, cousin? It's been a while.
Yeah, I ain't seen you since you was caught in Evelyn's bed.
A guy was never proved.
You gotta go, both of you. My girlfriend, she'd kill me if she knew I had guests.
Well, it's not much of a girlfriend if she don't like your family. Now, would you get me a fucking drink? I'm not gonna ask you again.
Oh, yeah, okay. Wait, I ain't got no booze.
Well, then you go out and fucking get me something. You go, too.
All right, okay.
Fuck.
You don't even have to leave your car. She just reached through the window, wanky, wanky, wanky. Hey, bloke, you want a cockatoo? You know.
Okay, dude. Okay, girl, there is a big wrecking ball outside, and they're gonna smash your house down.
We know!
Calm down, bitch. You're gonna ruin my hair.
Master, you taught me discipline. Why haven't you paid the bills?
I was very distracted. I have a 300-year mortgage to pay, and my pension got cut. It's a hard time for everybody.
Pension? I thought you was an ancient ninja master, is what you told me.
I am. Many years ago, I was an ancient ninja postmaster. About 5 years. Then I retire on a 275-year pension. I can draw a postcard and call the home. I can do a terrible paper cut. The post office was horrible. Licking, stamping, licking. God damn it. It's like being with my second wife. Your face goes numb. You take a coffee break and run back to a sad, crushing job that leaves you feeling terrible afterwards.
Hello, master.
Thank you.
two down there, power ballad boy. Let's talk to the big chief and hear from him. You!
Well, William, you know, you are so ugly. Ugly! Even Laszlo would turn out the line. And you sing like Jez Torrent's asshole after a curry. come on, mate. One guy calls you talentless, ugly, and a waste of space on national television, and you...